I'm about to launch from the shadows like a lion on the grind coming at you. I'm a menace for the vengeance, so relentless. Hope you ready, cause I'm here to battle. Keeping me awake till the late night. Thinking about a wrong, I'ma make right. When you see me, better take flight. Venom in my veins, and I'm all out of play nice. And it's bye-bye gone to the bygones. Ain't no turning back when the fight's on. When you see the white in my eyes, better run, better hide. No surviving what I'm on.
I ain't here to play around. If I were you, I would run right now. Make your feet bang, bang on the ground. Cause I'ma hunt you down, down, down. I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down, 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 yeah. Cause I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down.
What is up, guys? Dashing here for episode number 3 of Aftershock. It was supposed to be last night, but I got a little bit tired, like the little baby that I am. So we're doing it tonight and tomorrow, Sunday, the day of our Lord, will be Octane and Ignition. But we are kicking things off here this evening with some tag team action in the women's division as we see Isabella Almas make her way to the ring. Going to be teaming up with Anna Nixon to take on the duo of Maggie Shaw and Xiaorong. And last week we saw Isabella Almas pick up her first win here in CMV, defeating Xiaorong one-on-one, but via nefarious means, had her feet on the rope. Xiaorong certainly not happy about that after the match, going on Twitter, letting her thoughts be known on what Isabella Almas pulled, and Isabella saying, hey, it's a win. You gotta do what you gotta do to win in this business. We're seeing this trend continue so far this season, the rookies battling the vets, as Anna Nixon, who made her debut last week, looked great against Mina, but in the end took an L, so she's out here tonight looking for her first victory. It's a hell of a team these two are going against in Maggie Shaw and Xiaorong. The Women's World Championship Tournament beginning yesterday on Shockwave. We saw both Ashley Rain and Gianna Di Natale advance to the semifinals. And tomorrow on Octane, the other half of the tournament going to commence as it'll be Jade Divine versus Ashley Riot and Keio versus Mina. And a new Women's World Champion will be crowned in 2 weeks' time at Point Break. Live from Canada, the Great White North. These two rookies. As Isabella Almas showed last week, not afraid to bend the rules to get that dub. Second generation superstar Maggie Shaw had a so-so season thus far, a loss to Ashley Rain at Revamp, but Maggie Shaw actually holds a victory against Isabella Almas a couple of weeks ago. We know Maggie Shaw still fixing to get her hands on the Women's Hardcore Championship, trying to rack up those dubs. Xiaorong trying to put the past behind her here in the new season, this new era, everything that happened with she and RVW, and it's not how she wanted to get things started last week, that loss to Isabella Almas. But Xiaorong, we talked about it last week, man, she's looking great physically, mentally as well, though. But she is a bit peeved, wanting to give Isabella Almas her comeuppance here tonight. Later on tonight in our main event, guys, John Reed will make his first defense of the CMV Openweight Championship when he defends against Andre Rogers of Aurelius. Saw Andre Rogers last night on Shockwave tap out John Reed in that tag team matchup. Will he do it again here tonight? Will Aurelius capture the open weight championship? Also going to see the return of Hikiko, who we have not seen in quite a while here in CMB. She'll be going one-on-one with Chloe Marks here tonight. Let's find out if it'll be another upset for Isabella Almas here against Xiaorong. Start things off against Maggie Shaw. Oh, rings that bell. Of course, Isabella Almas, the winner of the CMV Invitational. Before this new season began, she and Andre Rogers, the victors, getting themselves contracts here in CMV. And we've seen Andre Rogers do quite a lot thus far in a short amount of time. Isabella looking to follow suit. Maggie Shaw not taking it easy on the Rook, though. Also here tonight, guys, Hunter Quinn will be in action after his return. Last night on Shockwave, a loss to Samuel Valentine. In that post-match attack, you know, Quinn is pissed off. Looking to take out his frustrations on Fletcher Landon. Maggie Shaw, meanwhile, has Isabella Almas in trouble here against the ropes, dropping her chest first on the top rope. Cheeky jab into a carnival tie-up. Spins her around for a backslide driver. Point Break, guys, just a couple of weeks away. Did have a huge match made official over the last 24 hours. Ellie Quinn calling out Joy Justice, challenging her to a street fight. Joy Justice responding, agreeing to the street fight stipulation, and so it will go down. Over the border, Great White North. Joy Justice, Ellie Quinn one more time in a street fight. After Joy Justice cost Ellie Quinn that match against Ashley Ray and cost her a shot at the Women's World Championship tag to Maggie Shaw. Love what I saw from Anna Nixon last week in her debut. Mina ended up getting the better of her in the end, but see if she can make up for that here tonight. Going toe-to-toe with one of the most lethal strikers in the women's division, Maggie Shaw. There we see one of those Texas jabs. Now an Irish whip. Sends her back into the corner, though. Clothesline and a snapmare. Rolling neck snap. Quite a combination brought together there by Maggie Shaw. Pushed back by Nixon. Power no bow tie-up. Looks like Nixon will get the better of Maggie Shaw. Throws her down with that STO. Walking her over to the corner very slowly. Took too much time, and Maggie Shaw able to break free. Some more jabs in action. Quick elbow, didn't see that coming. Kick to the gut, though. Just back and forth here between these two. Anna Nixon willing to stand and bang with the second generation superstar. Another STO. Stomp to the gut there as she goes after the arm. It's going to be a big night of action next week on Shockwave, my friends. Not one, but two title matches, as we will see Aurelius, Chris Diamond, and Andre Rogers challenge Renaissance for the Unified World Tag Team titles. Chris Diamond won the Unified World Tag Team titles alongside Ace Reeves at CyberSlam. Feels as though they belong to him. Well, he's got his chance. We'll also see Andrew Briggs challenge Pierre Thompson for the Intercontinental Championship. Kicked to the back there by Anna Nixon, now walking Maggie Shaw over to the ropes. Targeting that sternum, now going to make the tag to Isabella. Whether you agree with Isabella or not, you got to do what you got to do in that ring to get the job done. The fact that she pinned someone the caliber of Xiaorong, no matter how she hit it, not to be understated. Beautiful springboard crossbody there. Not enough to get the job done, though. Knee to the back of the head, and we see Isabella already full of herself after only one victory. Up to the top rope she goes, gonna look to fly here. The question is, will it pay off? Yes, it will. A phenomenal looking Swanton bomb. Isabella all over Maggie Shaw right now, like peanut butter on jelly as she drops the leg, getting funky. Having some fun at the expense of Maggie Shaw. Maggie Shaw continuing to fight, though. She's got to make a tag right about now. Things not looking too good for the second generation superstar. Calling up a tie-up. Isabella now with some power. The military press, and I think I know what's coming next. That standing moonsault. Power and athleticism. What more can you ask for? Still crazy to think that Isabella Almas came from the CMV forums. But now being in the CMV ring and athletically gifted, that's for sure. Kick to the side of the head. Maggie Shaw finally going to make that tag to Xiaorong. Great drop kick catching Xiaorong. She was looking for a kick of her own. Forearm smash. Put her down with authority. And Nixon going to give Xiaorong what she wants here. An opportunity to lay hands on Isabella. Walked right into that bangarang, though. Jeez, please, Isabella. Not taking it easy on Xiaorong here. Out onto the apron she goes. Waiting patiently for Xiaorong to get up to her feet. Springboard, phenomenal forearm by the rookie. Hooks the leg. Will that be enough? One, two, no. Very nearly 2 weeks in a row, Isabella almost had Xiaorong beat. Now she goes to the top rope, though. She ain't done just yet, my friend. Oh, my God. An imploding Phoenix Splash. One, two. I have to imagine would have been a three count there. Not for Maggie Shaw breaking up the pin, and Isabella going to make her pay for that. Just walking her around the ring here. Breaks free to Shaw, giving Xiaorong an opportunity to get back up to her feet. Oh, what a kick by the Empress, who now backs into the corner. Punt kick missing, though. Lucky for Isabella Almas. Almost had her head taken off right there. Elbow to the gut. Turning into a brawl here at ringside. Xiaorong been waiting all week to get her hands on Isabella. Damn, single underhook knee right to the gut. Spinning soul kick by Almas as we see Anna Nixon watching closely from the apron. Up to a count of five already. Xiaorong thrown down on the outside unceremoniously here at the hands of Isabella Almas. Continues to try and make her mark. Big boot to the face. Going to turn her inside out. Count of seven now, and Xiaorong does not seem to have a care in the world. Another single underhook knee to the midsection. Those are going to start to add up. She's loving it, man. Hey, if it works, why not? If it ain't broke, don't fix it. 10 count here, having until 20, as we know, to get back into the ring. Isabella might have some broken ribs right now after all those knees to the midsection. Another leg drop. Very jittery there on the apron. Man, Isabella going hard right now. 15 perhaps, looking for the count out victory. Look at that. Isabella's like, job done. Remember what she said. You got to do what you got to do to win. Xiaorong not out of the fight just yet, my friends. Tag made to Anna Nixon as Rong gets back into the ring. Targeting that knee. Goes for a slap kick to the midsection instead by Xiaorong. She can't get enough. Everybody getting a taste of that knee. Back in comes Maggie Shaw. Charging, the rookie gets caught with a drop kick. Overhand punch denied. Collar and elbow tie up. Going after that left knee with a dragon screw. Maggie Shaw finally gonna counter that STO. Kick to the midsection by Nixon. Looking to close that distance to the forearm smash. Countered by Maggie Shaw. Like a game of Pong here. Back and forth, back and forth. Going for the Shaw driver. Countered though by Anna Nixon with an incredible power bomb. Now, how about that? And now Anna Nixon with a rolling unprettier. Is it game over? One, two, No, it is not. Maggie Shaw, Valiant here. And these fans in attendance chanting tag team wrestling. This has been a great matchup thus far to kick off Aftershock number 3. In comes Isabella Almas, kicked to the midsection by Maggie. The DDT. Bring Xiaorong back in. Not a bad idea after taking that rolling unprettier collar elbow tie-up Irish whip into the corner. Slow approach here by Almas. Snapmare drags her into position. Some more incredible athleticism. A body splash off the top rope. Not again! 1, 2! Oh, Xiaorong not going to be cheated twice. Kicks out of that dirty pin, but Isabella waiting for with a pedigree. 1, 2, 3, no! Wow, Anna Nixon taking out Maggie Shaw with an alley-oop. Xiaorong somehow kicking out of that pedigree, and now we get a Fisherman's driver. Nixon continuing to beat down Maggie Shaw. Out onto the apron. What the hell is Isabella doing here? She's going after Maggie Shaw. Maggie Shaw, for some reason, drawing the ire of Isabella. That allows Xiaorong to capitalize. Back into the ring we go. No, Isabella. She's wanting to lay hands on Shaw right now for some reason. Counters into a clothesline. Counters that kick with an elbow to the knee. And into a back suplex kip up. Leg drop combo. Up to a count of 4. And Isabella wants this fight in the ring. She wants to finish Xiaorong off once and for all. Xiaorong sleeping on her feet though. Isabella decides can't wait any longer. Holy shit. Xiaorong, wait a minute, with a Dante Driller. Big fan of the bastard Dante Tatum. That butterfly pile driver, no doubt cracking the skull of Isabella Almas. Now it's Xiaorong who gets back into the ring, mocking the rookie. Isabella not going to take that lion down. Comes up from behind, but gets an elbow to the jaw. Stuns her long enough. Xiaorong with a knee to the gut. Spinning knife-edge chop attempted. Here we go. Xiaorong is not a little gal either. Military press standing moonsault. Successfully pulled off by Isabella. Maggie Shaw offering to tag Xiaorong in no condition though to comply. Took that combo. Look at the kicks. Oh, and the final one right to the side of the head. Xiaorong, as tough as they come though, able to brush it off, make the tag to Maggie Shaw. Top rope. Maggie Shaw certainly has a strategy here, try to keep Isabella grounded after seeing her high-flying abilities in this matchup. Easier said than done, though, it would appear. Goes for a powerbomb, countered with a back body drop. Now Maggie Shaw dragging Isabella into position. What the hell is she looking for here? Grabs her by the hair. Oh, what a punch! Square to the nose. 1, 2. Broken up by Anna Nixon, though. Maggie Shaw, not going to let that stand. Throws her down to the outside. Making sure to focus on Isabella here, and not just one leg drop, but 2. This could be Maggie Shaw's opening. Rolling neck snap. Isabella in serious trouble here with Anna Nixon down at ringside. But look at this, Maggie Shaw gonna give Xiaorong the satisfaction. Xiaorong looking to bring home the dub. Isabella to her feet. Oh, another punch to the jaw. Ooh, meet the back of the head. Face first goes Isabella into the canvas. Frequent tags here between Maggie Shaw and Xiaorong. back in as the second generation superstar. Isabella looks to be in La La Land right about now, my friends. And Maggie Shaw again has the Shaw driver denied. Quick to make a tag to Anna Nixon. Honorable tie up, Irish whip into the corner. Over the eye. Anna Nixon explodes out of the corner. Going for another drop kick, but that would not connect. Pays for it. Hangman's neck breaker. I think the real question is, Hawks, what are you? A couple of elbows to the gut, gonna set Anna Nixon free. They respond with a kick to the midsection as Maggie Shaw. And once again, back and forth these two. Spins her around. German suplex. Picture perfect. Hot tag made to Xiaorong. The Empress gonna go right after Nixon. Nixon taking on everyone right now by herself. Numbers game gonna catch up to her. Face first off that top turnbuckle. Not just once, but twice. Thrice? No. Kick to the gut. Look at Xiaorong popping off with a barrage of elbows to either side of the head. Anna Nixon able to push her off. Now Xiaorong going to play games with Anna Nixon, adding insult to injury with a stomp to the chest. Very methodical as Xiaorong when she wants to be. Brings Maggie Shaw back in. Stomp right to the ankle. Will the third time be the charm for Maggie Shaw in this matchup? Twice she's tried for the Shaw driver. Twice it's been reversed. Tornado enziguri. Good night. And now out of the corner, Anna Nixon. Everyone's a big Dante Tatum fan in this match. Decapitate him to Maggie Shaw. Hooks the leg. One, two, no, not enough. The veterans, man, really giving the rookies a run for their money here. Isabella almost back in off the tag. Maggie Shaw seeing stars right now. And Isabella immediately gonna hit her with a pedigree. Decapitate him into the pedigree. One, two, three, that's finally enough. The rookies victorious in a great tag team matchup to get things started here tonight. A hard fought battle between these two teams, but the rookies prevail. Isabella Almas and Anna Nixon with an impressive display here tonight. The show is not over. Put up the wrong screen. That was only our first match. We still have plenty to go. And up next, Hunter Quinn, my friends, is in action after his return last night on Shockwave. Did not go the way he wanted it to. A loss to Samuel Valentine. And then after the match, Valentine beat him down even more. Hunter Quinn not happy about that afterwards, saying Samuel Valentine will get his, but his main focus is still Pierre Thompson and that undisputed world heavyweight champion. Even in defeat, Hunter Quinn saying he showed everyone just how lethal he is now. Did beat the hell out of Samuel Valentine. That's the reason he lost, because he wouldn't go for the win. He just kept beating Samuel Valentine. Hopefully Quinn does not make that same mistake again here tonight as he goes one-on-one with Fletcher Landon. course, Hakiko makes her return to CMV. She will go one-on-one with Chloe Marks. And in our main event, the CMV Openweight Championship will be on the line as Andre Rogers challenges John Reed. You were a big fan, weren't you, babe? Just the biggest lone wolf, Mark. Shaking my head. Saw Fletcher Landon in action a couple weeks ago. Went one-on-one with Gabriel Seto. Great match the two had. Of course, Seto victorious on that night. Fletcher Landon out to collect his first dub here tonight, taking on Hunter Quinn. Easier said than done. Where's Marty Bateman? Where is he? That's what we're all waiting for. Slate's waiting for him. Hopefully Fletcher Landon prepared here. We saw just how brutal Hunter Quinn was last night against Samuel Valentine on Shockwave. Hunter Quinn with a new look, a new attitude, and a new mission. That's to take the Undisputed World Heavyweight Championship from the hands of Pierre Thompson, alive or dead. I think he sent a pretty strong message to not only Pierre Thompson, but everyone else on the Shockwave roster with what he did to Samuel Valentine. Never has anyone looked stronger in defeat. But again, hopefully Hunter Quinn does not make that same mistake against Fletcher Landon here tonight of not going for the win when he has the opportunity. Triple H is still looking for that match, man. So here we go, Fletcher Landon, Hunter Quinn. You know, if Hunter Quinn really wants to get his hands on Pierre Thompson, he needs to focus more on collecting dubs. See, straight out the gate, he's got a considerable size advantage here against Fletcher Landon, picking him up and dropping him face first on the top turnbuckle. That's one way to get a match started. Now into the full mount, and those left hands going to connect clean with the face of Mr. Landon. Tries for a standing shooting star, but all he's going to get is the knees of Hunter Quinn, the psycho killer. He kicks the midsection into a German suplex. You know, guys, we're not that far away from getting the Road to Ascendance 10. Still can't believe it. Still trying to wrap my head around it. Ascendance 10. Just a couple of months away. My favorite time of the year. Of course, we are just 2 weeks away from Point Break. We're along with a whole lot of awesome action. We will crown a new Women's World Champion. Look at this, rear naked choke by Hunter Quinn with the body scissors and everything. Fletcher Landon in trouble, big trouble early on. Well, I thought he was about to tap there for a second, but looks like he's actually able to escape. Nicely done by the rookie Fletcher Landon. Great combination. Still not enough to take Hunter Quinn off his feet, though. Barely affected him. throwing Fletcher landed overhead like it ain't no thing but a chicken wing. Calf kick again. Hunter Quinn not willing to budge. Snapmare. Elbow to the top of the head. Nice soccer ball kick. Goal! Fletcher landed a bit hesitant here, and he's going to pay for it. Kick to the top of the head. Knife edge chop. Collar and elbow tie up. Fletcher Landon now walked over to the corner. Oh, man. Busted open is Fletcher Landon after getting smashed face first on the top turnbuckle. Goes for a running knee to the temple. Fletcher able to avoid that. Looks like Fletcher's bleeding just above his right eyebrow. See if that becomes a target for Hunter Quinn. I'm sure it will. Smells blood in the water. You go against Hunter Quinn, you know you're going to be bleeding. Hammerlock suplex by Hunter Quinn. Knife edge chop, cheeky jab, and again. And now the fuck it, as I like to call it. And a punch to the bridge of the nose. Gonna bite the finger, man. Hunter Quinn doesn't care. Whatever he's gotta do, he will do. This journey he's on to capture the undisputed world heavyweight championship. Elbow to the midsection by Fletcher Landon. Pushed back though by Hunter Quinn. Kick to the knee. Again pushed back by Hunter Quinn. Fletcher Landon trying to stand and bang. But the devil dog summoned from hell. Pushed back. Oh, cross body to the back of the head. And just like that, Hunter Quinn may be looking for the kill shot. Just slapped his ass. gave him a slap on the bum. Oh, Quinn with the release tiger bomb. That might do it right there, my friends. One, two, three. Hunter Quinn victorious, not playing games here tonight. He went for the win when he had the opportunity, and it paid off. Hunter Quinn with a successful performance here tonight against Fletcher Landon. Pierre Thompson, now that he's the undisputable heavyweight champion, he's got a target on his back. That's expected. Gonna have to have eyes in the back of his head because Hunter Quinn is on the hunt for that undisputable heavyweight championship. And coming up next in our co-main event, my fine feathered friend, before things are capped off in our main event, Andre Rogers challenging John Reed for the CMV Openweight Championship, we see the return of Hikiko. I have not seen her in a very long time, but joining this stacked women's division here in the new season and looking to make her return a successful one here tonight as she goes one-on-one with rookie Chloe Marks. Of course, her mentor, her teacher, Troy Colt, going to be in her corner here. Colt preparing for action tomorrow night on Octane. He's set to go one-on-one with Adam Valentine. That should be an incredible matchup. Don't want to miss that, that's for sure. Last time we saw Chloe Marks in action, though, she did take a loss to Neon thus far in her singles career. Things have not been going so well. Maybe, just maybe, things will turn around here tonight against Hikiko. Delay yourself, fool. And how much money? How much money to get Marty Michaels to be the host of Ascendance 10? Name your price. Put it on the table. Drake can move aside. Him and Xander say they need to ride off into the sunset together, you know? You know what else is a big one? Chloe Marks looking for a big win here tonight against the returning Hakiko. Troy Claude has done his best over these last few weeks to train Chloe Marks, and she has looked pretty good her last couple of outings, but still has yet to get a win on her own. Still tripping on that bottom rope, though. Still hasn't gotten used to that just yet. That thing's tricky, you know. Ask Batista. Again, this women's division, guys, here in the new season is stacked from top to bottom. So many new faces who have already proven themselves in this very short amount of time. And Hakiko back. Looking to fight the best of the best. To test the waters here tonight, though, against Chloe Marks. Still to come in our main event, guys. Andre Rogers looks to bring the Openweight Championship to Aurelius as he challenges John Reed. That should be a great matchup. Legendary Yuki Ito. We need that Japanese invasion. Not that kind of invasion. Just in time, Brad. For our co-main event. As Chloe Marks gets set to go one-on-one with the returning Hakiko. Hakiko looking phenomenal, by the way. Been a very, very long time since we've seen her in a CMV ring, though. I'm sure she stayed busy as she tosses Chloe Marks into the corner. Bashes her face first off that top turnbuckle. A popular move this season here in CMV. Kicking at that midsection. Troy Colt watching at ringside. Shouting orders. Giving advice, but will it be enough? Ooh, into a triangle choke here. Wasting no time is Hakiko. Trying to knock off Chloe Marks. Wants that dominant dub in her return. Send a message to the women's division. Tying up them legs. Marks gonna fire back with cloverleaf pain. Chop, and again, three times as a matter of fact. What a deal. And into a simple but effective vertical suplex. Chloe Marks getting there, rolling neck snap. Tries to stomp the ankle. Hakiko rolls out of the way, charging her, looking for an enziguri. Overhand punch instead. Jab to the jaw, turns her around. Woo! What a neck breaker by Chloe Marks. There you go. Troy Cole happy to see that, I'm sure. Rolling neck snap to continue targeting that neck here is Chloe Marks. Now the arm. Troy Colt didn't want this. Didn't want a rookie draft in his lap. He's made the most of the situation, that's for sure. even though Chloe Marks has made his life a living hell. Not just in the Performance Center either, but overall. Troy Colt's got to feel some sort of pride, though, that our new owner of CMV, Christopher Wright, gave him this mission, this duty to train Chloe Marks. Oh, damn, open palm slap down across the chest. Now a trio of kicks to the chest and a snapmare. Gonna roll to the front, kick to the face. Doesn't get much more straightforward than that. Akiko ain't gonna stop there either. Looks like we got ourselves out. Oh, man! Modified Samoan drop hooks the leg. One, two. Very nearly done in. Chloe Marks kicking out at 2.999, but Hikiko is not finished, my friends. Chloe Marks not out of the woods just yet. Fisherman's driver. Good night. Hooks the leg. One, two, three. Oh, look at that. Hikiko telling Poe, come on now. Oh, and here comes the knee caught by Chloe. Chops it away. Champ and the fans saying fight forever. They like this match, apparently. Been very fast-paced since that bell rang. Hikiko continuing to try and make short work of Chloe. Drops an elbow across the face. Chloe Marks looking to pull off that upset, and she very well may. Rolling fireman's carry senton. Hooks the leg. Hang on a minute. One, two. Oh. Troy caught with his arms crossed here at ringside. Doesn't seem all that impressed. Maybe he'll change his tune, though. It's Chloe Marks with an Irish whip going to send Hikiko out onto the apron. Using that apron as a weapon now. We all know it's the hardest part of the ring. Beautiful back suplex rolls up to her feet as Hikiko. Chloe Marks waiting for her with some jabs to the jaw. And now a half Nelson suplex countered by Hikiko midair. Throwing Marks forward. Drop kick puts her down with authority. Some more kicks to the chest. There's one to the back of the knee. Oh, and a super kick to complete that combo. Hikiko, pardon my French, kicking the shit out of Chloe Marks in this match. Literally. Up to a count of seven. Chloe Marks with a tilt-a-whirl small package. Of course, she can't win here at ringside, though, except maybe by count out. She can't go for the pin. Hikiko looks to be out of it, though. Grabs that kick, turns it into a dragon skidoo. Count of 10, my friends. Battling are these two in the corner. Chloe gonna throw Hikiko down. 12. Boy, Marks doesn't seem very concerned with Poe's count right now. Another knee drop missed, though. Hikiko rolls out of the way. Hikiko trying to get back to the ring. Chloe Marks stopping her. Single knee to the back. Guys, up to a count of 15 here. Dangerous territory. Knees to the gut. 17, kick to the side of the head by Chloe. She does not care. 18, Chloe Marks back in the ring. Wait a minute. Can Hikiko wake up in time? 19, oh my God. 1 second left. What a save, double leg takedown by Chloe Marks. There we go, Troy Colt coming to life at ringside. He's liking what he's seeing now. High kick by Hikiko. Oh no, another fisherman's driver. And there you go. One, two, three. Hikiko with the victory. What a match though. Great matchup here between these two. Hikiko with a little bit more to give though on her return to CMV. I really thought that was gonna end by count out there. Very nearly did, 19. And there's the second fisherman's driver that did the deed for Hikiko here tonight. Great win in her return. what I call it, not even checking on Chloe. Come on now. And now, lads and gents, it is main event time here on Aftershock number 3. CMV Openweight Championship going to be at stake as Andre Rogers of Aurelius challenges John Reed of the Kingdom 3.0. It was just last night on Shockwave in that tag team matchup that Andre Rogers tapped out John Reed. He'd do it again here tonight and bring the Openweight Championship to Aurelius. Going to have a busy ringside area, too. Chris Diamond and George King spectating their respective stablemates. George King, you can just see that look on his face, man. George King never had a good mood, but especially kicked off right now with Chris Diamond getting the better of him. Last night, George King wants Diamond's head. Just hoping, though, that John Reed can keep the Openweight Championship around his waist. Reed, of course, winning it a couple weeks ago on the first episode of Aftershock, defeating Jeremy Barmore. It's his first defense. Will it be his last? Could see Andre Rogers with two titles to his name by this time next week, just a couple of weeks into his career, because, of course, Chris Diamond and Andre Rogers will be challenging Renaissance for the Unified World Tag Team titles in the next episode of Shockwave. Diamond wants all the gold. Wants what he feels is owed to him. He and Ace Reeves won the tag team titles at CyberSlam last season. How come Renaissance gets to keep them? Well, he's got his chance. Take him back. Next episode of Shockwave. We're here tonight. Spotlight on Andre Rogers. Chris Diamond choosing to go his own way at DEF CON 3, not sticking with John Lipnick, not joining George King either, instead forming his own faction, Aurelius, where he's the leader, recruiting Andre Rogers and Eminence. All the gold be coming home to Aurelius over the next couple of weeks, along with $100,000 potentially. We know that Big Money Inc. and Eminence can be battling in that $100,000 ladder match in the next episode of Shockwave. CMV Open Weight Champion John Reed with his first defense here tonight. And honestly, John Reed and George King alone, a dangerous combination, but they were expecting to have Chris Diamond by their side at this point. George King gonna continue to scour the CMV roster for a third member. Right now, he's got a score to settle, though. Hoping that John Reed, ensure that Chris Diamond doesn't again get the best of the Kingdom 3.0. So let's get it on. Main event time here on Aftershock number 3. CMV Openweight Championship up for grabs. Andre Rogers thus far undefeated in his CMV career. Got two skilled submission artists going at it here. It might just be whomever gets their signature submission locked in first walks away tonight as open weight champion. John Reed got that dragon sleeper. Andre Rogers got that, whatever the hell you want to call it. He tapped out John Reed with last night on Shockwave. That stretch, that nasty stretch. Looked like he was about to rip John Reed in half. You know Reed wants to avoid that at all costs. Go CMV Open Weight Championship, baby. Andre Rogers for Aurelius. John Reed for the Kingdom. Chris Diamond and George King at ringside. Nice combo by Reed straight out the gate. Clapping Andre Rogers. Heel of his boot right to the back of Rogers' skull. Full mount by Reed. Open palm strikes trying to break through Andre's defenses. And well, John Reed certainly putting Andre Rogers into a world of hurt in the first minute of this match. Now look at this bending back on the fingers. Very methodical. It's the fallen angel. And of course, this bloodthirsty CMB crowd, as always, chanting break his fingers. They want blood, they want carnage, they want absolute destruction. John Reed willing to give it to him. Oh, and here comes a wicked knee to the face by the CMB Openweight Champion. Goes for the pin, will that be enough? One, two, no. Says enough is enough with these combos. Looks like he's a bit hesitant to approach Don Reed here. I don't blame him with this match is going so far. Taking too long. Deciding what he wants to do there. Pays for it. Oh, and what a knee. Down goes Andre Rogers. John Reed looking for that modified crossface. Stomp to the quad by Andre. And the dragon screw. Box suplex. And send Reed into the corner, making George King cringe at ringside. And Andre adding insult to injury there. Apparently once isn't enough. Jeez, three times in a row here. Andre Rogers having his fun, ladies and gentlemen. And now some stomps to the chest. Well, this match has definitely changed pace. It is all Andre Rogers now, whereas John Ree was dominating towards the start. Have you ever seen a wrist clutch assault, my friends? You're in for a treat right now. Look at this. George King can't believe it. Can't believe what he's seeing here at ringside. Andre's got the arm in a hammerlock position. Bending back on those fingers. Confident enough now to bring John Reed up to his feet. Collar and elbow tie up. Irish whip into the corner. Cautious approach by Rogers. Going after that arm. Trying to tear it off, it looks like. Ooh, nice. John Reed escaping the corner. My God. Some serious bitterness behind those boots. Giving Andre Rogers a good old-fashioned face wash. Here comes another knee. This time goes for the pin. Will it be enough to retain the CMV Openweight Championship? No, only a one count. Bateman, where's NGW Impact, huh? Oh, man, you can't stop with these knees. Another pinfall attempt. One, two. Barely a two count, though, for the champion. Can't believe it wasn't enough. Stomp to the midsection. Going to pop Andre Rogers up. Andre a little bit too quick there for John Reed, though. Throws him down to the outside. And Andre going to have some more fun at John Reed's expense here at ringside. Side headlock, headstand, showing off. Uh-oh. Andre Rogers trying to further injure that arm of John Reed, targeting it. Throughout this match, you know how badly George King wants to come over there right now and knock Andre's head off, but doesn't want to risk the disqualification, or maybe he does. John Reed, he can retain via disqualification, via countout. Andre Rogers has to win by pinfall or submission in the ring to leave tonight with that Openweight Championship. Just throwing Reed ribs first into the steel security wall, and now Andre Rogers mocking John Reed, saying, come on then, get back in the ring and let's dance. Breaks the count at 10. Reed now gonna throw him gut first into the steel barricade. And the one night stand from the fallen angel. Striking from the Openweight Champion. Geez, throwing Andre Rogers right into George King. Bouncing off King. Going back first into the steel barricade. And now it's John Reed mocking Andre Rogers from inside the ring. John Reed saying, come on, I'm right here. I ain't going nowhere. Oh, Andre Rogers squaring up to George King here, though. Gets himself distracted. What a kick by the Openweight Champion. George King just refusing to move here. He's standing his ground. Jeez Louise. John Reed turning out the lights. The knee right across the face. There's a forearm smash. Andre Rogers out. He's sleeping. Andre Rogers on Dream Street right now. Breaks the count at 6, does John Reed. Great blocking by Reed. Can't block that pendulum backbreaker, though. Will Aurelius get the upper hand on the kingdom again here tonight? You hear that freaking dong? John Reed's head off the steel post echoing throughout the arena here. Back suplex! Are beating the hell out of each other, man. Up to a count of 9. Again, John Reed has that champion's advantage as he bends back on the fingers of Andre Rogers. 11 count. Boom! Quick kick to the side of the head. Andre back into the ring. Going to save himself. Will John Reed take the easy way out here? Looks like he's maybe thinking about it. But no, he wants to beat Andre Rogers definitively. Whoa! John Reed rolling back into the ring, and Andre was in quick thinking. Springboard body splash. That was pretty awesome. Pulls him out up into a back suplex. Reed, just like that, man. Ain't playing around. There's the Dragon Sleeper off the cutter. Andre Rogers, will he be the one tapping here tonight? Yes, he will. John Reed is still the CMV Openweight Champion. John Reed tapped out last night, but Andre Rogers did the tapping here on Aftershock as John Reed retains the Openweight Championship. Hard-hitting matchup. The Kingdom still in possession of the Openweight Championship and get themselves a win against Aurelius, much to the chagrin of Chris Diamond there at ringside. Why does John Reed have to be mean to Poe, man? What did he do?